Today we will going to cover basic concepts regarding the multimedia data, multimedia database, multimedia data retrieval methods, and classification and prediction over multimedia data and association mining in multimedia as well. So these topics we will cover, and we will get to know how the important information can be retrieved from the multimedia data. Let's understand what is multimedia first. So what is multimedia? Multi means many, media means medium, whatever. So what we are having more than one media exist. And why we use this multimedia system? Because we want to present some information, some idea, to convey some other persons. So because of this, we are using various kind of media. Say for example, if we are using only text, so it is not very effective. Okay, if we are using multimedia and some audio systems, okay, some lecture you are listening, you will get to know more. But if you are using all the different media in the combinations, say for example video, lectures, and you can include animation and other things. So what you will do, you will learn more the basics of any concept. So it will be very helpful to understand. So that's why we are having different current variety of multimedia systems. So in these today's digital world, this is now increasing day by day. So what are the basic elements of multimedia which constitutes this multimedia data? So it may have audio, it may have the video, image, graphics, speech, text, document, also the hypertext data which you find in the websites, and it contains the markups and linkage also, that is the navigation, navigation purpose, we hyperlink those things. So what are these? These comprise the multimedia database systems. So this is the database system stores and manages a large collection of multimedia data, such as that we discussed here. So what are the categories of multimedia systems? Let's understand. So basically there are two categories of multimedia. One is the static and another one is the dynamic media. So in the static media, which contains the digital libraries containing the SMS, okay, images, photos, medical images. Okay, so static means they are not variable with the time. They are not having any time parameter in dimension. Whereas your dynamic media contains such as audio and video, the music and video also. So what is it? This is the dynamic media, and this is also called the one more name it is told, that is the continuous media. Means what is happening, suppose you are listening one song, okay, some speech you are listening. So we have the time with respect to the time, okay, the data is changing. You are listening the song for example 3 minute song is there, 1, 2, 3 you will listen. So you can slide, you can go at a particular time, some particular, okay, voice or audio you will listen. So that is why, and same for the video. So that is why it is called the dynamic media. So this is the two broad classifications of the multimedia data. Next, you can see here it's the same thing, dynamic media. You have the video with respect to the time, you have animation, audio, and text, graphics, images. These are nothing but the state example of the static multimedia. Next, you need to understand, because we need to understand what is the basic things that constitute any image. Because of the with the help of these, we will do many mining tasks over the multimedia data sets. So there are two terms we have, the raster and vector graphics. Two types of graphics we have. So whatever images you are looking into the internet, okay, they generally constitutes two varieties. So first one is the raster. Raster image is nothing but the it is composed of pixels. So these pixels will constitute the image, and each pixel represents the color. It pixel, suppose this one. So this is nothing but this pixel. Okay, pixel means picture element, and this combined, and we can say it is a pixel. So this, so pixel is a very it is the smallest unit of any image, raster image. In that, each pixel represents some particular color. They represent some color. Okay, like here you can see here this pixel blue. This one is the yellow, green, and this type of coloring you can see here. So what is this? All my images, they are composed of pixels. As we increase the number of pixels, image quality increases, because the pixels gets denser. But when we increase the size, because of this, the problem comes whenever we increase the size, like we zoom the images which are of raster, which are of raster kind, then you will see after some extent you can enlarge. But if you go beyond that, your image quality will degrade, blurring, you will say, you will not be able to visualize what is there. Okay, at some particular point it will be okay. If you go beyond, the image quality will degrade. Okay, so this is the story of your raster images. And we have another kind of graphics, the images, like that is the vector image. In the vector image, we don't use any the pixel concept. We use the point and curves, point and lines, to draw the any image. So like here you can see, we are putting dots, like here you can see here, and then what we can do, we can join these lines, and then we will get to know the image, what is the image, then image will come out. So this is the vector type of thing. So these two very famous system of image representation is there. One is the raster, and one more thing in the vector, what happens whenever we are increasing the size of the vector images, the image quality doesn't degrade, because they what will happen if you will increase, what will happen, the distance between two points will increase. Okay, because they will govern with some mathematical formula. So scaling, translation, everything you do, no problem will come in this vector images. So we use this type of techniques. Okay, and also we need to know different coloring models. So we have the RGB, that is the red, green, blue, and this is web optimized color scheme. In website, web designing, whatever image we are putting as a multimedia data, so this they follow the RGB model, the value of red, green, and blue, the quantity of these value. And if I say it is representation of 8-bit, okay, we are representing the 8-bit, then what I will go, so for each color I can have 2 to the power 8, that is 256 varieties. Okay, so 256 combinations will come from this, also 256 from this, also 256. So you can get 2 to the power 24. So this much of color you can draw when you are using the 8-bit representation in the RGB model. So we can represent each pixel in distinct colors. So this type of features are there, and it is very compulsory to know at the time of doing the image processing and this multimedia data mining. So these are the basic concepts that I told, the difference between the vector image and the raster image. Okay, now come to the multimedia data mining. So multimedia data mining is the discovery of interesting patterns from the multimedia databases that store and manage large collection of multimedia objects, including image data, video data, audio data, as well as the sequence data. At times series data is also there, na? And hypertext data containing text, text markup and linkages. So these are the different type of data in over which we'll perform the mining task, and then we'll get to know what are the interesting hidden patterns are there we can extract out. Okay, so multimedia mining, it is treated as a interdisciplinary field. So in that we have the image processing, we have the computer vision. Okay, very famous CV2 is there in the Python. You can use, you can work with the images, you can create the different object detection, okay, traffic monitoring system you can create with this. Okay, and also like face identification in the video, that these mining please mute yourself. Hello, please everybody mute yourself. Next, we have the data mining, and this is the pattern recognition. So it is not one, it is a combination of different interdisciplinary fields that constitutes this mining task to be successful. So what are the different issues in multimedia data? So it includes, okay, content-based retrieval and similarity-based search and the generalization and multi-dimensional analysis. So these are the very challenging tasks. These are the different issues that exist in multimedia that we cover, and we are trying to solve that. So next we will see only the searching part of the multimedia data which are available in the database or a data warehouse, multimedia data warehouses. So similarity means whatever query you are giving, that query will match with the content, and according to that you will get to know what is the output. Say for example, in the Google search engine also you are doing the same thing. So can we apply this searching part in the multimedia data for mining the patterns or for searching the contents? Of course we can do. So here you can see the similarity searching in multimedia data. Two main family of multimedia: indexing, we do the indexing, and retrieval systems are there. Here first one is the description based retrieval system. Description means if I have one image, okay, say for example if I am having one image or I am having one video, then it has some descriptions. If I talk about the image, then it has some caption. Caption means we write the for which purpose, what is the name of this, not name, what this image is about, what. So the caption will be there, its size will be there, what is the storage in bytes. Okay, and its time of creation, its time of modifications, okay, location, so many things will be there that will describe the image. So this will describe the image. Based on that, based on the description, we can retrieve, we can extract, we can find out the data from the content from the multimedia data sets. So here what is happening? It will build the indices. Indices means, suppose we have the indices technique, row number wise also we have the indices. If I say row number 1001, so there will be some corresponding persons because this description is there, because with the help of these indices I will arrange the image. So if this matches, I will extract this one. So like this, which what is happening here, indices, and perform the object retrieval based on the image description. So whatever description you are providing, if the description matches or the matching content will be taken up and it will be displayed to you. So this is happening like this. So, but a description based retrieval is very labor intensive. It is very tedious task. Because it is very tedious? Because for this keyword or captioning and these captioning and keywords maintaining and tagging to the image, it is very difficult. It is very, very not difficult, but it is very, very tedious task. So if automated, if we can automate this tagging part, then it, we can do. Of course, we have we have studied this automatic tagging in the previous lectures also. So the results are typically of poor quality. Even if we do all those things, the result will not be of that quality that we are desiring. So what is happening? You can see here the assignment of keyword to images can be a tricky and arbitrary task. So recent development of web-based image clustering, okay, and classification methods have improved the quality of the description based. So web image retrieval, because image surrounded text information as well as web linkage information can be used to extract the proper description and group images describing a similar theme together. So in the Google search engine, you can see if we put some description, if we put some query in the search box, so correspondingly we are getting the images in image section. So they are classified, they are clustered together also. We can see, I will show this with the example in the later slides. So you can see, you know what are the descriptions that we can get from the image. Suppose you are having one image in your system. So over that, if you right click like this, if you go to the properties, so in that properties, in the general, you can see the what is the location where it is there in the your system. See the size on the disk, the date of creation, date of modification, date of accessing, everything you can see here. If you go in the details, more details, then description you will get, though it is not there, but this can also be there. This information can also be kept. If the image properly, the image is in the internet, we can get these informations. So you can see here, whatever the information is there, descriptions is there, we can use this for searching purpose. So dimension is also there. You can see height and width. Dimension means we can see here, this is the okay height and width you can see. So we have the width 251 and this height, and resolution also 120 dpi. Okay, 120 dpi. So and vertical resolution is 120, like this. So you can see this type of information we can extract from the image that is stored, and based on these descriptions we can extract the image, we can extract the multimedia data. So you can see here in the next part of similarity search in the multimedia, next one is the content based retrieval system. So previously we were doing the descriptions that we have kept the associated with the image, but now here our focus is on the content based retrieval. So you can see here it supports retrieval based on the image content. And what are the image these features are there? So we can use the color histogram. So any image that we are having, say for example this one example is there, iris from that image we are taking here. So what is this? This image will certainly have the if we are using in the internet, I told we are using the RGB model. Okay, if we, so RGB means red, green, blue, these value will be there associated with the image. So we can create this histogram for that these values. So based on that, if the histogram is matching, so all the matching histogram images which contain the similar histograms we can extract from the data sets, multimedia data sets. So next is the texture. You can see here texture. What is the texture? We can see the we can use this information also, the patterns. Okay, and image topology also we can see here in the it is in the 2D, 3D or okay, multi-dimensional. So this can also be used, and shape of the objects and their layout and also the location within the image. Suppose this is image is there, in that one location is there, these are the locations. So in shape of the object and their layout and locations within the image. So these all informations, okay, these content informations can be used, okay, because these content information is part of the image. It is not the description that that we have written by ourselves, like data creation. So it is, you can see here, it is a different than the descriptions in the previous methodology of content, methodology of description based retrieval system. So this is very important, and many of the work has already been done in this. So we'll see some of the methods in details also. So you can see here, content based retrieval uses the visual features to index the images. So based on the visual features, whatever these visual features are there, we'll make the indexing of the image in the data sets. So when this visual feature will match, the image will be popped up to before you, and promotes object retrieval based on the feature similarity, okay, which is highly desirable in many applications nowadays. So there are two kinds of queries again for this one. One approach is the image sample based queries. We'll put one sample, okay, and based on that I will get the answer. So next one is the image feature specification queries, okay. So there are this is the two query kinds of queries in the content based retrieval systems. One by one we'll see here. You can see here now, image based sample based query find all the images that are similar to the given image samples, okay. So this search compares the feature vectors or signatures. Feature vector means whatever feature is there, for say for example, so in that feature means we have the histogram, we have the texture, we can have the texture, we can have the pattern, okay, location. What are these? These are the different features. So combinedly we can say it is a feature vector. So these value we can use for the indexing purpose. So what is happening here is this feature vector, also we call the signature. So extracted from the sample with the feature vectors of images that have already been extracted and indexed in the image database. So based on the this comparison, okay, these distinctions, images that are close to the sample image are returned. So here we can see we are looking for here proximity, approximately similar those images are, they will extract and will get. In the Google search engine we have some this you can see here this camera icon is there na? Whenever you will click here na, you will go to the image mode. So what you can do, you can put the image here in the search query. So based on that, see, you can see here image descriptions, resolution is there, whatever dimension is there, resolution will be there. So you need the small size, medium size, large size, which type of image you want. So it will be coming, it will come. So the all the images which is similar to your query that you have, see, I kept this query in the image form, and now I retrieved the all I will retrieve all the similar images which is resembling this lotus image on the water, okay, flower that live in water, whatever description will be there, it will come. So if you want, I can show this one. Let me switch the slide, 1 minute. Yeah, you can see here. I hope you are able to see. So what I did, I clicked here. Okay, I kept here one image, and then I got this. So which category of image you know, need of size, large, small, or what? Suppose I want this medium one. So I clicked here. You can see here. I kept that one image, and similar images I am able to see. You can see here whatever the images are there in the internet. Now I am able to get. And you notice here we are here in image sections. So what is happening? We have all these groupings. We can see video, images. So based on this categorizations are there. So further you can also see any color, these descriptions, okay, uses like this. Based on these features you can do. So this Google search engine, it is a very good tool for understanding this data mining in multimedia systems also. You can learn here many things. Okay, this is the very important thing that you can know. So for that you have to go here, then you have to put the paste, you have to paste the URL of the image, or directly you upload the image, then the searching will start. Okay, so all the, you can see here the clustering, classification, things that you have learned, you are able to visualize here. So this I try to make you understand with the help of this. Okay, next, image sample based query you have seen. Next one is the image feature specification queries. So you can look here. What is happening here? It is basically we are going in the content based retrieval system. So image feature specification queries specify or sketch image features like color, texture, or shape, which are translated into a feature vector to be matched with the feature vector of the image in the database. Okay, so based on that we'll do. So now note down, we can note down here, content based retrieval has wide applications in medical diagnosis. So for example, some image, medical images of brain or any body part that has been taken with the medical devices, diagnostic devices, then this retrieval system can use for in that purpose. So here you can see here weather predictions, we can also using in weather predictions. We have the different images, based on that we can predict what is the, because there are different features there, and this feature will tell some story, they will predict. Okay, based on the image, TV productions, web search engines for images that I shown the examples, and e-commerce also. So they are widely used in these many areas as a image data mining systems. So what is this? Query by image content. Next one is the query by image content, QBIC. So this support, this is the hybrid of both description based as well as the content based retrieval system. So we are combining here that we name query by the image content. So this description, this support both sample based and image features specification query. So there are also system that support both content based and the description based retrieval system. So we need to know. Next one is the approaches for similarity based retrieval in image databases. So what are the different methods that we use? So first one is the color histogram based signature. Signature means you can say the feature vector. Next, multi-feature composed signature. Next is the wavelet based signature, and the fourth one is the wavelet based signature with the region based granularity. So these are the four approaches that helps for similarity based retrieval in image databases. Okay, so one by one we will see what is the meaning of these color histogram. So First one is the color histogram based signatures. You can see here some description is there. So in this is approach, what is that? Signature means the feature vectors of an image includes the color histograms. Okay, color histogram I told based on the colors, okay, available in the image, the some histograms will be created for all the colors. So based on the color composition of an image, regardless of its scale or orientation, so doesn't matter what is its size, whether it is a small size, okay, or bigger size, doesn't matter, the image size doesn't matter, but we'll see the pattern of the histogram color. The color histogram will try to match, and its orientation, its direction is also whatever direction is there in the image, that doesn't matter. So but we will keep on only focus over the histogram, color histogram that we got. Based on that we can find the image, this similarity we can use. But this method doesn't contain any information about the, say, image topology, whether it is a two dimensional, three dimensional, okay, what is the texture, what is the structure of that, whether it is a rough or it is a smooth kind of thing. So that texture also doesn't it contains, because it is only based on the color histograms. So thus two images with similar compositions, color compositions, but that contain very different shapes or texture may be identified as similar, although they could be completely unrelated semantically. Okay, so this type of shortcomings, this type of flaw is there in color histogram based signature retrieval. But anyway, up to some extent this can help for retrieval of the image. Next one is the multi-feature composed. So in the previous we had seen only we are considering only the color, okay, so that's where two images may be different, semantically different. But even if even though the system is retrieving the image and saying this is a similar, so that problem now can be removed by applying some of the more features. So we have taken first the color histograms, now we are also considering the shape, image topology and the texture also. So these all together will be used for retrieval of the images. Okay, the extracted image features are stored as metadata. Whatever feature is there, suppose I am having one image, and for that image these features, whatever the feature will be there, means it is not data, but it is the that will be a metadata for that particular image. So that metadata can be used for indexing purpose also. We can index in the our database system whenever some person is searching based on that similarity of the index, already indexed value, the image immediately will be shown to you, or it will be retrieved. Okay, so often separate distance functions can be defined for each feature and subsequently combined to derive the overall results. Okay, so combined they can be used. So multi-dimensional content based search often uses one or a few probe features to search for the images containing such similar features. So we have the multi-dimensional means we are using the image, so image may be having some format also, like it is a JPG format or what format is there. We can see the another one feature, we can see the histogram, one more feature we can see what is the size, it is a oval kind of thing, square. So shape we can also consider. So other the different features we can take for probing the feature. It can therefore be used to search for similar images. This is most popularly used approach in practice. So if we are searching the images with the help of the multi-feature composed signature, then compared to the previous method, that is histogram based, it is more accurate. Next one is the wavelet based signature. So this approach uses the dominant wavelet coefficients. Okay, find image as it's part of your image processing. Basically, image processing is a separate field in that these wavelet transformations and the different things we study. But as of now, we'll see the method how we are using here in our this image retrieval systems. Okay, so wavelet captures the shape, texture, and image topology information in a single unified framework. Okay, so this they consider all together these features and they perform this task. This improves the efficiency and reduces the need for providing the multiple search primitives, unlike the second method. In the previous one, we have seen we are applying color, shape, image topology, texture, so many things, but we have limited here. Okay, we have limited here. So, however, since this method computes a single signature for an entire image, it may fail to identify images containing similar object where the object differ in the location or size, because we are not considering this feature. So this problem may be there. But even then, in this approach, that is the wavelet based signature with region based granularity. So in this wavelet based signature, we had combined the many features in a one unified in a single system. So using that, we had captured the images, we have retrieved the images. In this, we will also include the region based granularity. Region based means the particular place in the image at a granular level we will keep, and we will also use that information for better retrieval of the images from the multimedia databases. So you can look at here the computation and comparison of signatures or at granularity of regions. Granularity of region, say for this is my complete one image, so I can pick one area here in the whole this whole slide. So this will be the granular level. So I can take this this area. Okay, so as a sample purpose here. Okay, and I will use this one as a sample for matching with this combination of wavelet based signature. So here I will combine like a color, size, and the topology of the images and this sample. Then this together will find the image similarity based retrieval more effectively compared to the all other three methods. So here what is happening? So this is based on the observation that similar images may contain the similar regions. That is why this is our intuition, this is our main concept principle behind this which we have tried to build. So but a region in one image could be a translation or scaling of a matching region in other. Okay, so scaling and translation is the two very important operations in the image processing that we can use. Scaling means we can scale if the size is, suppose this one is one cube, if I will scale it, this is 1 × 1 × 1, so what I can do, I can scale 2 × 2 × 2 × 2 like this. I can scale the size, I can increase the length, height, width, and height. I can. So this is nothing but the scaling. We can translate. Translation means we can move from one place to another place. Okay, in the suppose XY axis is there, we can translate. Suppose some object is here, and I can translate from this place to this place. Okay, by proper adjustments. So this translation. But translation means the image shape and size will not change, because we are only translating from one place to another place, translation operation. Okay, so therefore similarity measure between query image Q and target image T can be defined in terms of the fraction of the area.
okay, fraction of the area, not the complete one, of two images covered by matching pairs of regions from query Q and image target image T. So such a region based similarity search can find image containing the similar objects where these objects may be translated or scaled also.
So next one is the multi-dimensional analysis of the multimedia data. Means multi-dimensional means we have more than one dimensions, and like in the we have done in the transactional and transactional databases, we did then in that we did the OLAP operations. Okay, so in that way we can also model here. In the transactional database, suppose we have taken the we have modeled the data sets into the with respect to the different dimensions. Say for example, if we are taking three dimensions here, because more than three it is not possible to visualize properly here. So suppose I am taking this year, this time, okay, I am this dimension, I am taking the location, and here I am taking the product. So in the transactional databases, we create the data cubes like that. So suppose time, I can make these dimensions. Okay, we can go roll up and roll down. We can do these operations here. Okay, so locations like, say for example, I have chosen some city, and I have chosen here the some product like computer, laptop, and this is the product dimension. Here the time dimensions means it may be the month, year, month, quarter, year. Okay, so like that, this time dimensions I can see. So based on the time, suppose I can find out some items purchased in a particular, say suppose for a particular month, and as a particular location, say for example in New York City. Okay, in New York City, okay, in month of June, and for the laptop product, how much, okay, sale has happened. So this type of things we already did in the, and we know the this concept can also be now here can be applied in the multi-dimensional databases, multi-dimensional analysis for multimedia data. So you can see here same thing, we have tried to create analogy. So you can see here we can take the attributes like color here, this one dimension is one dimension, okay, and the color may be whatever the combination will be, RGB model or whatever model we are using. This is the size means the how much storage capacity in bytes it is taking, and this may be the this way may be the format of the file format, like I can take the, this is JPG and GIF. So you now can clearly visualize that this can be modeled in the multi-dimensional mechanism also. So you can see here this multimedia data modeling, and it is analogous to this one as we did in the OLAP, the data cube generation. So here you can see some literature is here. Multimedia data cube can contain additional dimensions and measures for multimedia information such as color, texture, shape. See color, whatever color is there, different colors we can see here. Okay, these color dimensions are dark, red, light, red, like this. Okay, texture is the means that whether it is smooth or the smooth is rough surface is there, and what is the shape, it is a oval kind of thing, square kind of thing. These things can be taken as a dimensions. So these are the additional dimensions that we got. So we have to select the prominent dimensions while creating these multimedia data cubes. So you can see here with this example, it will be very much clear. You can see here we have one dimension, we have taken the colors. Okay, next one is the, if I say two dimensions, so I can include the format also JPG, GIF, bicolor, and here by format, and you can see here bicolor also, when the red, white, blue, like this. If I fix this region, so this color is red suppose, and this the file format is JPEG. So like this two-dimensional representation can be done. Same thing, we can create the multi-dimensional. So multi-dimensional, you can see by format and color. Okay, we can see in different dimensions as we seen in the previous slides, size. So this thing, and what we can do, we can create the slice and dice also. We can create the slice and dice operations are there. We have seen in the data cube lab and multi-dimensional data modeling, we did the slicing and slice and dice, the different operations we have created. So that also can be done in this with the respect of your multimedia data sets while creating the multi-dimensional data models. So what are the different dimensions that we can consider? These are the few dimensions are here, like format of image, duration, color, texture, keywords that we use for searching purpose, okay, size, okay, width, height, the internet domain of the image where it is stored, internet domain of the parent page, okay, and the image popularity. This is the few of the steps. This is the few of the dimensions that we consider. There may be more dimensions also we can consider here. We can consider the captioning also, okay, like this. So next one is the classification and prediction analysis of multimedia data. As we did after modeling of the data, we can do the classification and prediction over the multimedia data sets. For example, you can see here we have the classification and prediction modeling, how we can do. So multimedia data can be used in scientific research, okay, astronomy, okay, seismology, that is related to the earthquake, and geoscientific research. So these are the different areas, okay. So in this, astronomy means related to the space. So these many things we can, in all these fields we have the multimedia data sets. So in these fields the multimedia data sets can be used for different type of classification and prediction purpose, okay. So and most of the classification methods can be used in image analysis and pattern recognitions. We can do the pattern recognition, we can find out some particular type of patterns. So moreover, apart from this classification clustering, the classification, some classification methods like we can use here, we can use the support vector machine, we can use the KNN, that is the K nearest neighbor. We can also use the logistic regressions, is there, that also can be used here. And we can also use other like ANN, artificial neural network, Bayesian classification methods. So BN can also, so a lot of methods that we had studied in the data mining, that classification method are applicable here also, we can do once. But we have to model the data in such a way that the data can be fetched in these, they can take this, that can be fetched in these classification methods, okay. So apart from this, we also need some statistical calculations also, that is also very important, that that may help to make, to create a powerful and high quality models for the classification and predictions also. Like say for example in regression methods, once the data is converted into the numerical format, the regression can be applied very easily. So here statistical value can be used. Classification and prediction analysis of astronomy data. So in the astronomy data, that is related to the celestial bodies, so in that what we can do, there's some very good example is here, we can see here. So taking sky images, okay, at a particular time you can take the sky images. We have the powerful observatory systems at high magnifying telescopes also that are continuously working in the research centers. So what is happening here, these sky images that have been carefully classified by the first, this can be classified by the astronomers as a training data set. Once we created the training data sets, so these training data sets can again be used as a to train the model. And once the model is trained, we can use this model to recognize the galaxies, stars, okay, stellar objects based on the properties like magnitude, area, light intensity, image movement and orientation. So because if we talk about some celestial bodies like black hole or any star, okay, they have the certain image, they have their certain orientation, they have the certain intensity of light, magnitude, area, and they have the particular patterns. So we can identify this one, we can predict what is the celestial body meant. So if once the model is trained, we can easily do, and it is possible if we are able to model the data into the format accepted by any classifier. So like this we can use. So a large number of sky images taken by the telescopes, okay, our space probes can then be tested against the constructed model in order to identify new celestial bodies. So similar studies have successfully been performed to identify the volcanoes on Venus. So how we from the Earth we get to know that Venus is having the volcano active and idle. So that is only possible because we are not able to go there, but we have that powerful telescopes, we can take the images, and based on the image we can if once we have trained our models, then it can easily classify, it can also easily predict what is meaning of that. Next one is the, because we already modeled the data, so here in multimedia data image can be treated as one transaction, as we have seen the transaction in the databases, in the transactional database. Suppose for transaction T1 some person has purchased some products, okay, say for milk, bread and butter. So market basket analysis that we did, we have heard, and there are so many association methods that can find the frequent patterns. Say for example we know the a priori algorithm in that by using the support and confidence value we can find the particular patterns, some association we can find. Later on we also have some more efficient algorithm like FP growth that can also be used. Okay, so this is the association kind of things. So next one is some of the query that we can use for finding the association. First one is the associations between image content and the non-image content feature. So image content means whatever I am having the image inside, some content is there, or some image is there, some shape is there. So this is the image content, and after that non-image content features means its shape, size and description, caption, so many things. So using these two combinations we can find some association. So say for example you can see here, if a rule like if at least 50% of the upper part, so here the 50% of the upper part you can see here, generally when we take the photo of the sky, then we take some part as a ground and upper part will be the sky, and sky color will be blue type. So you can see here, so if at least 50% of the upper part of the picture is blue, then it is likely to
present sky, represent sky. So this type of representation we can give and belongs to this category since it links the image content to the sky word. So whatever image captioning keywords we have kept, okay, so this can be matched with, because we are finding this type of patterns, and whatever the caption, whatever the descriptions we have kept in the image content feature, non-image content feature, so that can be used for the finding the associations. So this association among image content that are not related, so we can also find the not relationships to the spatial relationships. We can find this type of negative associations that they are not related. This type of also query we can do. So a rule like if a picture contains two blue square and then it is likely to contain one red circle as well. So belongs to this category of, since the association of all are all regarding image contents. Next one you can see here, association among image content related to the special relationships. So here you can see the rule, if a red triangle is between two yellow squares, then it is likely to likely a big oval shaped object is underneath. So this belongs to this category since it associates object in image with the spatial relationships. So these are the few discussions that we have done under the multimedia data mining. Okay, so with this today we are wrapping up this lecture. In the next lecture we will know the mining of the multimedia data in audio and video. So thank you so much.